What's wrong with me?
Tests indicate toxic agents in your blood and lungs. You will have respiratory complications for the rest of your life.
I work in this hospital. How could this have happened?
We use chemicals that are known to be harmful to human health when constructing and maintaining this building.
People come to these places to get well. What happened to do no harm?
The healthcare industry is one of the largest consumers of energy in the United States, second only to the food industry, with a consumption level 2 times higher than the average commercial building.
An amazing 13 tons of laundry need to be washed each year at large hospitals. Expensive sources of energy, such as redundant backup systems, must be available at all times. Finally, the transportation of sick patients expends large amounts of energy annually.
The United States Green Building Council, a proponent of sustainable design in the U.S., ranked the healthcare industry last out of all building types in the adoption of sustainable design practices and their popular LEED rating system for green buildings, comprising only 2% of all registered projects. In addition to being large-scale consumers of energy, the healthcare industry also struggles with environmental health and safety. Along with the diseases and infections present in a healthcare setting, the powerful and toxic cleaning, disinfecting, and sterilizing agents used to clean the hospital and its complex equipment can seriously harm both the patient who may be compromised and staff as well. According to the National Institute for Occupational Safety and Health, healthcare workers account for more than 40% of all cases of adult-onset asthma, one of the leading work-related illnesses. So how do we address this kind of problem? How do we make hospitals both perform better and provide a healthier environment for patients and staff? The answer can be found in environmentally conscious design. Research has shown that sustainable design can recoup its own costs many times over, both in energy and resource savings, and in increases in productivity and health. In addition to these monetary gains, numerous studies have shown that by adopting environmentally conscious design strategies, such as increasing indoor air quality, controlling sources of moisture, and reducing the use of toxic chemicals in maintenance and furnishings, significant reductions can be achieved in flu, asthma, nonsarcomial infections, and sick building syndrome symptoms. In addition to these health benefits, reductions in these illnesses lead to gains in productivity, which on a national scale can save the healthcare industry billions of dollars every year. But do industry professionals agree that green design is the proper course of action for healthcare?
Absolutely. I really do. And one of the things that it makes sense on a number of levels. One, obviously, is because hospitals in particular are the most intensive users of energy and water sources and so on. Anything you can do to reduce that amount of resource and to do it in a sustainable way makes sense for the organization. But it also makes sense, and another reason for doing this is that, you know, this is supposed to be an environment that heals people. It's supposed to be an environment that not only doesn't make you sick, but should actually make you better in a healing way, for not just the patient, but for the staff.
Despite the significant benefits which can be realized through sustainable design, the industry has not yet fully embraced environmental and socially responsible design and maintenance, and several misconceptions still remain.
The first is, again, is the widespread perception that just green costs more. And there's starting to be evidence that that's not necessarily the case. If you look at the same program, the same amount of scope of work, it often can be the same kind of cost. But that perception is a widespread one.
Contrary to this conception, a 2003 survey of LEED-accredited buildings found that the average cost premium for LEED Gold performance was only 2%, with a less than 7% cost premium for LEED Platinum performance. To begin to create change in the industry, we have to start by educating industry leaders and stakeholders in the importance of environmentally beneficial design and the monetary and medical benefits of its application.
Education is one component of teaching someone about sustainability, but it doesn't end there. Although you have to be informed about something, it's also important that you apply that.
One strategy that has been effective in enabling change in the healthcare industry is the adoption of Green Champion or leadership programs.
The idea is that from the sustainability officer, these people will take the different ideas of sustainability and disseminate them.
These kinds of programs have already been used in industry-leading organizations such as Kaiser Permanente and many others. To learn more, log on to globalhealthandsafety.org. Thank you.